Good afternoon. I think it was very positive that we had this extraordinary Eurogroup meeting because we do have a full agenda. There's not much time left till the Euro summit in mid-December. So this was an important step to make sufficient progress. A few words from the ESM perspective. Let me start with the agreement that the ESM and the Commission reached on our future cooperation. I'm very happy with that agreement because I think we found a good balance that can draw on each other's comparative advantage. On the one hand, it gives a stronger role to the ESM. That's what our member states wanted. But at the same time, the agreement respects fully the mandate and the competences the Commission has from the EU legal framework. If we compare today's ESM with the predecessor, the EFSF, obviously the ESM has grown a lot over the years. Initially, we were only in charge of getting the money from the markets and provide it to program countries. But in the case of Greece, the last few years, we have grown into the Troika, which became the Quartet, because we are the largest creditor by far for Greece. And this gave us certain insights and experiences, which I think can be used in the future in a productive way. So the agreement spells out in some detail how we will cooperate in normal times outside of programs, and of course, how we will in the future prepare, negotiate, and monitor adjustment programs. The details you will be able to find in the paper that will be published later today, probably immediately after this press conference. On the backstop, this is obviously a crucial element to complete banking union and therefore also important for deepening EMU. The June summit already agreed that the ESM will provide that backstop to the SRF. We are now working out the details, which are sometimes very technical, but we are making progress in that work. And today, the main question the ministers dealt with was whether the common backstop could be activated earlier than 2024. The chairman went through the details and don't need to repeat that. But I would like to add that the markets, and you know the ESM, we are in contact with the markets basically every day. They're also expecting clearly some progress in this area, finishing the backstop. Of course, that also means we need to make progress on risk reduction, which was discussed today as well. On the debt issues, let me also say clearly from my side that the objective of this discussion is not to make debt restructurings more frequent or automatic in any sense. The objective instead is to have more clarity and predictability, also to avoid delays in a crisis that can be costly. And we know that markets would also welcome to have more predictability, so it can actually help. Also, for changing the CAGs again is something where we, and based on our analysis, would not expect any adverse market reaction. Actually, it could be quite the opposite, that markets also take it in a positive way. I think that's all I want to say. Thank you.